will be getting underway for the Yankton Gazelles. The Gazelles last season with a record of 6-15, 3-8 in the ESD. They lost to O'Gorman in the Class AA SODAC 16. O'Gorman went on to win the AA title. They take on the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots tonight, who were 10-14 last season. They got eighth place at the South Dakota State AA Girls Tournament in Rapid City last March. And Michael Schumacher joining us tonight. Michael doesn't have Tanager basketball until Monday night when the Tanager girls will take on Canton in their opener. So Michael is running the computer and the camera tonight, and always a lot of expectations with the start of a basketball season, Michael.
There always are, you know, especially with what the Gazelles lost from last year with all that senior leadership. You know, a lot of unknowns. But, yeah, there's always that every season you start anew and you wipe out the record from last year. And looking forward to seeing what these girls have to offer.
Yep. Right now, the sophomore game is going on. There's 7:37 left to go in the sophomore game. And Lincoln High School leading Yankton by the score of 37-15. But earlier in the JV game, Yankton defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln 40-23. Kai Lily Medina led Yankton with 10 points. It was Kaylor Llewellyn with 8 points and Adeline Skelhaus with 7 points. So one win for Yankton, but Sioux Falls Lincoln has a big lead in the sophomore game, 37-16, with 7:19 left to go. Well, we told you this is the start of the girls' basketball season. Actually, there are a handful of games tonight. No other AA schools are playing tonight or Saturday. They will start coming up next week. As a matter of fact, the first girls' basketball game of the season in 2022-2023 happened last night at Great Plains Lutheran, where Sisseton defeated Great Plains Lutheran 66-28. And now coming up tonight, Centerville will take on Hanson, and Gerritsen will take on Baltic. Crazy Horse will take on Ulrichs. Coleman Egan takes on Freeman. Freeman Academy Marion takes on Cologne. Canastota against Dubrook area. And those are the games that are scheduled tonight. So, hey, with no other AA games on the schedule tonight, we will give you updates of the games that are being played in Class A and Class B across South Dakota on the Fox Stop scoreboard, brought to you by the Fox Stop, located on the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st Street in Yankton, open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily. Full-service convenience store, hot food, sandwiches, munchies, beverages, the cellar, and the video lottery room with pay at the pump gas and diesel fuel with firewood and propane tank exchange. This is the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. We'll dive in a little bit more about preseason rankings in Class AA, Class A, and Class B with 6 minutes to go in the sophomore game here at Sioux Falls Lincoln. Lincoln now leads Yankton 37-16, 5:50 left to go in that game. Let's take a 2-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll have more as the Gazelles open up their season here at Sioux Falls Lincoln. Back after this 2-minute timeout on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube.
The Evergreen Credit Card by FNBO. Earn unlimited 2% cash back on every purchase, every day, everywhere. Never worry about expiring points or category restrictions. Plus, there's no annual fee. Only from the Great Big Small Bank, a bank ever ready for you to earn more, wherever life leads. Evergreen by FNBO.
Few facts about Larry's Heating and Cooling.
It's Linda at Linda's Angel Crossing in Yankton.
The fall styles for the ladies has come in. It's tribal and Jag and Ethel and Charlie B. Find casual wear, business attire, and a beautiful dress for an evening out. We've also got the kiddos department, Under Armour in the girls, boys, and baby departments. Kiddos sizes range from 2T to 14. And if you're shopping for a baby gift, come see me. I'm open Monday through Friday, 10 to 6, and Saturday, 10 till 5.
Wing Wednesday is a huge hit.
Naturally handmade soaps, sugar scrubs, lotions, shampoo.
You want somebody to come into your home and fix everything right the first time, look professional, act professional, treat you with respect, you gotta call Caitlin's. When they come in, I feel that they want to be there. I feel that they want to help me.
You know, they put on the little booties over their shoes. They had canvas from the garage door all the way down to walk on. They left the furnace room in the basement probably cleaner than it was when they came in.
They just do customer service very well. I would recommend Kalen's to anyone.
Back at Sioux Falls Lincoln on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. So much care, so close to home. As the Yankton Gazelles open up the 2022-2023 season on the road here at Sioux Falls Lincoln. In the sophomore game, we're about halfway through the fourth quarter. Lincoln leading Yankton 39-18. Well, Jason Andera of Midco Sports conducted a coach's straw poll, and here's what the coaches said that might be some teams to watch in all three classes here in South Dakota. In Class AA, O'Gorman, the defending champion, is number one. Sioux Falls Jefferson, who upset Sioux Falls Washington in the quarterfinals of the AA tournament last March in Rapid City, is number two. Sioux Falls Washington is number three. Now, the Gazelles will play Washington coming up later this month. Our good friend Jamie Parrish coaches the Warriors, and he told me when the Gazelles played at Washington last year that, you know, obviously he had a great team last year. With Jack Yalenga, Wentanata, who is now playing Division I basketball, but he said the next couple years could be better teams for the Warriors. But, of course, you got to prove it on the court, and we'll find out with Sioux Falls Washington coming to Yankton coming up later this month. Brandon Valley from the ESD in the Metro Conference fourth. Pierre is fifth. Sioux Falls Lincoln, who the Gazelles played tonight, is mentioned at number six. Rapid City Stevens, number seven, Harrisburg, number eight, and Watertown, number nine. Now, in girls Class A, Vermilion is ranked 11th in the straw poll. Like we said, it's a coach's poll, but the Tanagers do have, Michael, a good team coming back for this season. And again, they start Monday with Canton at home.
They really do. They have every significant player from last year's 17 and 16 coming back. That team took St. Thomas More down to the wire in that SODAC 16 game. So, you know, everyone has their opinion, but boy, I think that Vermilion Tanager team is going to be something to really be reckoned.
Woolsey Wessington, number three. Centerville from southeastern South Dakota is ranked fourth. Then Howard fifth. Castlewood sixth. DeSmet seventh. Jones County is eighth. Wall is ninth. Sully Buttes is 10th. Balkton 11th, and Coleman Egan is number 12. So that's a look at the coaches' straw poll in girls AA, A and B. Again, put together by Jason Andera of Midco Sports. Let's take another timeout. And when we come back, we'll talk about the boys' coaches' straw poll from Jason Andera of Midco Sports. There's 1:59 left to go in the sophomore game here at Sioux Falls Lincoln. Lincoln leads Yankton 45-19. We'll be back after this two-minute timeout here on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 and five-star streaming.
Interior technicians.
Hey, troublemaker.
What'd you do?
What did I do about what?
Don't be coy with me, Jerry.
All the ladies in the salon were gabbing about it.
So why are you in hot water?
No, no, no. I'm not in hot water. At InTech, we use hot water. Our trained technicians use a hot water extraction process to deep clean your carpets without leaving behind any residue.
Wait till the Bunker Gals hear this.
Oh, brother. When you need it clean, call the InTech team.
It's time for a new...
Your first bank in South Dakota was the easy part. Earning the confidence of local farmers, helping families account for their dreams, and securing the future for countless businesses took us a little longer. We owe it to the hard workers, big dreamers, and forward thinkers out there. Thank you for making South Dakota a great place to call home.
Welcome to the great indoors. This is where we live. It's not always perfect. Things get messy, but maybe that's the point. At Explorers Credit Union, it's all about you. We get it. In fact, we made it our mission. People first. People first. People first. That's it. That's the difference. Discover the difference today.
So you can come in and enjoy one.
Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels Yankton has choices for a bride and groom and your wedding reception. Different spaces are available for your wedding reception and the price is very competitive. Have your wedding reception where they offer you plenty of time for the decorating you and your family want to do and plenty of time for cleanup too. At the Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels, you have 2.5-day venue that's all yours. See more by cruising the website, Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels.
Back at Sioux Falls, Lincoln, 12.7 left to go in the sophomore game. Lincoln High School 47, Yankton 21. Again, in the JV girls game, Yankton defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln 40-23. Kai Lily Medina led Yankton with 10 points. So, folks, we're going to be keeping an eye here in the last 12.7 seconds for the final score so we can bring it to you. But as we mentioned with the girls' coaches' straw poll, the boys' coaches' straw poll from Jason Andera of Midco Sports in Class AA, Sioux Falls Jefferson is preseason number one, and Michael, of course, coming off an 11 AAA football championship where Jefferson was virtually untouchable. Well, they were. They have some great athletes that will be on that team this year.
They really do. And, you know, in their second season in existence, Jefferson's kind of put everybody on notice that they're going to be a school worth contending with. They do. They're just a... They have a lot of good athletes, and those kids have worked together very well in the short time that they've been in existence. And, it'll be interesting to see how, with the target on their back, how they do this year.
All right, Jefferson number one, Harrisburg second. The Yankton Bucks will open up next Friday night with a doubleheader with the Gazelles at Harrisburg in ESD action. And that game next week, games next week, on Five Star Communications and on Five Star Streaming. Lincoln, with JT Rock as a junior now, the 7-footer, has had offers from Power 5 schools like Kansas. O'Gorman is 5th. Washington is 6th. Brandon Valley is 7th. And Roosevelt 8th. In Class A, boy, I tell you what, you're going to get an eyeful, Michael, of the Dakota Valley Panthers, the defending A champion and the heavy favorite to repeat again.
Yeah, with the next in the Bruns line, you know, coming through, it's going to be interesting to see. They're always well coached, and they bring back a lot of their talent. We're going to be seeing quite a bit of them. You always love seeing good basketball. You love seeing good players, but, you know, when they're opposing you, you don't always like to see it.
Yeah, no doubt. Dakota Valley followed by Sioux Valley, Del Rapids, Red Cloud, and St. Thomas More in the top five. Then it's Sioux Falls Christian at number 6, Groton 7, Lennox 8, Hamlin 9th, T Area 10th, Winter 11th, and Mount Vernon Plankington 12th. In Class B boys, White River number 1, Aberdeen Christian 2nd, DeSmet, Lower Brule, and Castlewood in the top 5. Then comes number 6, Gregory, followed by Howard, Wall, Del Rapids St. Mary. Canastota from the area is number 10, and number 11 is Ipswich. But, of course, the boys' season won't start until a week from now. All right, folks, we've got our countdown to tip-off going on here on the Gazelle Basketball pregame show brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. Sioux Falls Lincoln, again last year, was 10-14. They did make the AA girls tournament but got eighth place at Rapid City at the new monument last March. Sioux Falls Lincoln is coached by Matt Daly, who's in his 10th year, a graduate of Southwest Minnesota State. He is assisted by Scott Amundson. Marshall Bird, Zach Vogel, and Carly Soylent is a volunteer. And earlier today, we had a chance to catch up with Coach Daly to talk about his team and AA girls basketball in general and the matchup with Yankton tonight. Coach Daly, thanks for joining us on the Gazelle Basketball pregame show. Well, talk about your outlook for the Lincoln girls this year.
Yeah, you know, it's. I think we're in a very similar place as we were last year. We, you know, we lost two of our best jump shooters that graduated last year with Alana Sorensen and Addie Sand. So we're going to be looking for places for other players to step up and try to put some points on the board. But we do return our starting point guard and Addie Fawcett and our leading scorer and all-conference player in Mariah Stein. And we also return a third starter in sophomore Tierra Lubavitch. So, you know, we're in a similar spot. You know, we fought to get to 500 last year and battle our way into the state tournament. And, you know, we're hoping this year that we can battle our way back to that state tournament, hopefully win a couple games this year.
And also along the way, early on, especially in the month of December, it's usually that time to develop depth off your bench, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, and it's we have a great group of girls that have, you know, put time into the weight room and in leagues and open gyms, and we're really happy with our crew, great attitudes, and they've done a great job of improving their skill set and developing some cohesion and playing with each other since we graduated four. And, you know, we're excited. We've already, you know, sustained some injuries already in the first week that kind of made us readjust some things, but we think that, you know, in the long run here, we'll get a team that's prepared to make a run.
And I've seen some straw polls in AA girls, and of course, like we said, December's kind of the feeling out time before, you know, the dog days in January, and then all of a sudden you get into February and then into March and the season is over. But, you know, I got to believe that the Metro Conference is going to be the strength of AA girls. You know, hearing things about certainly Sioux Falls, Washington had a great team last year, but I'm hearing that they may even have a better team this year. And gosh, you got to throw in O'Gorman, you got to throw in Jefferson. I mean, it's you know, around the metro area, it's not going to be easy.
Yeah, you know, great programs around the metro area, I think. But I also think that a lot of those teams graduated a lot of talent. You know, when you lose a Jack Linga over at Washington, and you have a 6'4" girl that's off the roster, and they still have quite a bit of length, but they'll be trying to find some places to fill that talent. You know, with O'Gorman losing Rozick, a Division I player, they'll be trying to fill that gap with some athletes and some talent. And Jefferson, indeed, does have a lot of talent coming back. So those three definitely will be the tougher ones in the conference. But I think you also have some really good teams, you know, coming out of the ESD. I think Mitchell ended on a really high note last year, and they have a lot of their roster coming back. I think Brookings was playing good basketball at the end of the year. And it seems like the Rapid schools always bring a certain level of talent and are very competitive. So I think the field is a lot more even than it's been in the years past, and whether that's due to just lack of numbers, we're kind of seeing the numbers across the state decline, or, you know, just the cycle of not as many Division One girls basketball players coming to AA this year. But it will be an exciting year, and we're excited to get going.
Yep, and of course, Yankton is the opponent tonight, and of course, they were hit, you know, by graduation. So, like you said, you'll find out where you're at after, you know, a couple of weeks of practice with, you know, I guess the first and second quarter gone by.
Yeah,
yeah,
Yankton had a great squad last year. It's the longest and kind of tallest Yankton team we've seen in a while, and it looks like they didn't drop off that much with length with, you know, four girls that are 5'10". I mean, they're far longer than we're bringing to the table right now, and I think Claire Terzinski had a great year last year as a sophomore, and Macy Drossman had a great year as a sophomore, and those are definitely two kids coming back that have a lot of varsity experience that are super athletic and good basketball players. And but the first game is, it's always a crapshoot. I think it's tough putting together a great product in the first game because you never feel as prepared as you should be, and I think it's even tougher with us playing this game so early. I think we're about a week earlier than everybody else in AA with a game. So, you know, we probably have, you know, nine practices underneath our belt, and the first five were tryouts and where we couldn't get into, you know, a lot of the specific stuff that makes the team really solid. So it is. The first game is always a crapshoot, and it kind of comes out. I mean, who's going to probably shoot better and finish better, and the team is going to have less turnovers and make fewer mistakes early in the season. It's probably going to get the win tonight.
All right, Coach Daly, appreciate the time. Thanks for joining us on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show.
All right, thanks for having me.
Matt Daly, the head girls basketball coach at Sioux Falls Lincoln, on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. Yankton last season, again, was 6-15, 3-8 in the ESD, and lost to state champion O'Gorman in the Class AA SODAC 16, and graduated five seniors, Jillian Eisness, Jordan Salvatore, Kate Beeman, and Molly Savvy, and of course, one of the better guards in Yankton High School girls basketball history, Ellie Karlovitz. Trey Creer is the head coach of the Yankton Gazelles in his ninth year, a graduate of Mount Marty University. He is assisted by Amy Long and Jill Muth, and Coach Creer and I talked earlier today about, how these 2 weeks of practice before the season starts have gone, and the matchup with Sioux Falls Lincoln tonight.
Coach Creer, great to be back with you and the Gazelles for AA girls basketball in 2022-2023. And after a couple of weeks of work, it's time to go.
Yeah, you get to this point usually every year where, you know, we've had enough practices. We got to get on the floor and see where we're at and reevaluate the things that we think we're doing, reevaluate the things that we've talked to our kids about, and kind of trying to figure out what they are catching on to and what they're not. You know, we're inexperienced in our varsity level, and we gotta take baby steps forward, and that happens in practice very much. But at a point, you gotta get into a game and see where that stuff can start to carry over.
All right, talk about your starting lineup and the gals coming off the bench tonight.
Yeah, you know, we got Claire Terzinski back, a junior guard for us. Claire's played 2 years of varsity basketball for us. She was definitely the beneficiary of Ellie Karlovitz's misfortune and got a lot of experience as a freshman and a sophomore for us. She averaged 10 points a game for us last year and did a good job of finding opportunities for her to get looks at the basket. She's a very capable scorer, a kid that we're going to have to lean on heavily here this year to provide us with some consistent offense. Macy Drossman, another kid back from last year. Macy actually led us in scoring at times last year at the varsity level. Forward player who plays physical, isn't afraid to make contact with people, and we're going to look to her to hopefully provide a little bit more offensive firepower from us as well. Bailey LaCroix, another kid who saw some minutes last year. Bailey's a really smart player, junior as well. Who can run the guard spot, run the point for us, a good communicator, someone who's a capable shooter as well. So we're going to look for her to provide some offense for us at the same time. Cameron Kolecki, another kid who saw some varsity minutes for us last year. Cameron's a long body, really good slasher to the basket, really good at at offensive rebounding, getting some putbacks for us. So we're going to look to her to provide some offense for us. And then Peyton Mosier is going to round out our starting five here tonight. And Peyton's done a really good job in practice of providing energy. She's an energizer bunny, a defensive specialist. She's really good at getting up and pressuring the ball and then taking care of the ball in the offensive end. Off the bench, Camilla Kopp, a senior, our only senior in the group here this year, provides us with a big body. Emma Herwolt is another kid who can kind of transition between that guard forward position for us. Is going to be our seven that we're really going to try and rely on here tonight against Falls Lincoln.
All right, and Lincoln, who's been the opener the last couple of years, and you have to do it on the road tonight. And, of course, like you said, and historically, certainly, focusing on your squad, but, of course, then, it'll be, with the opponent tonight, Sioux Falls Lincoln, the first quarter, you've see what action on the court and make adjustments from there. Sioux Falls Lincoln had some graduation losses from last year, but understand that they return a couple players that they have to be concerned with.
Yeah, you mentioned we started with them for the last couple of years. 2 years ago, we got beat by them on our court on a last second bank in three, had an opportunity to win that game. Last year, we were within a couple points at the end of the game. They ended up pulling away with free throws and nipping us by about 10. So we've been competitive with them the last couple of years. And you mentioned they're in the same similar position that we're in, where they graduated some big pieces to their puzzle. And we're excited about our opportunity to go to Sioux Falls and start off our season competing with the Sioux Falls team, a Metro team. They're a very physical team. We're anticipating them putting some pressure in the full court. We're anticipating them mixing up some defenses, but being a very physical, aggressive team on both ends of the floor. So our kids are going to have to be ready for that physicality. That's not typically our MO. So being ready for that physicality, and then maybe most importantly tonight, Joe, is we got to take care of the ball. We got to limit the times that we go on offense without getting shot. And if we can get those looks at the basket, maybe we can limit some of their offensive runouts in transition, give us a chance to hang in there and find a way to be competitive for four quarters.
All right, Coach Greer, appreciate the visit. Go get them. We'll talk to you after the game.
Sounds good. Thanks, Joe.
Trey Greer, the head girls basketball coach at Yankton High School on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. As a point of reference, last year, Yankton as a team averaged 40 points a game, shooting 32% from the floor, 25% from three, and 59% from the free throw line, averaging 24 rebounds, 10 assists, 5 steals, and 14 turnovers a game. Claire Tereshinsky, as Coach Greer mentioned, is going to have to be the leader of this team. Last season, she averaged 10.3 points, had 39 three-pointers, shot 64% from the free throw line, had 27 assists, and 24 steals. Let's bring you tonight's starting lineups, brought to you by Larry's Heating and Cooling of Yankton and Vermilion for all your HVAC needs. It's Larry's Heating and Cooling anytime, any day. For the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots, at a forward, Sierra Velasquez, a 5'8 junior. The other forward, Kiara Lubovich, a 5'10 sophomore. And the three-guard set of Addie Fawcett, a 5'8 senior. Charity Lemire, a 5'8 senior. And Mariah Syme, she's a good one, a 5'8 senior. Expect to see Caroline Hughes, a 5'4 junior. Madison Evans, a 5'5 junior, Megan Oshner, a 5'8 senior, and Ashley Thuch, a 6-foot junior, off the bench first for Lincoln. For the Yankton Gazelles, at a forward, Cameron Kolecki, a 5'10 junior. The other forward is Macy Drotzman, 5'10 junior, and the three-guard set of Peyton Mosier, 5'5 junior, Claire Tereshinsky, 5'5 junior, and Bailey LaCroix, a 5'6 junior. Expect to see Addie Skelhaus, a 5'10 sophomore, Camilla Kopp, a 5'10 senior, Emma Herbolt, a 5'8 junior, and Kai Lily Medina, a 5'9 junior, off the bench first for Yankton. Other varsity roster members include Haley Shelty, a 5'5 sophomore, and Carly Chopp, a 5'7 sophomore. And, folks, we are going to pause for the playing of our national anthem, and then we'll continue with more here on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home, as the South Dakota Army National Guard is presenting the colors here at Sioux Falls Lincoln.
Please continue to stand and remain silent until the colors are retired. And ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
All right, the colors have been retired, and we're just about ready to begin. Sioux Falls Lincoln is in their home white, trimmed out in scarlet red, Columbia blue, and the Yankton Gazelles with their road red trimmed out in white. Our officials in tonight's game, the referee is Brian Gary. The umpires are Terry Jastrom and Drake Lower. This is ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK Vermilion Yankton, a proud service of Five Star Communications, and available online at kvtk.com, and also available tonight on Five Star Streaming. And Michael, when you subscribe to Five Star Streaming, you have a chance to win a $50 gift card just by hitting the subscribe button.
That is correct, and if you hit that subscribe button, you're notified of upcoming live streams. But yeah, when we hit 350 is our next benchmark, we'll be drawing for a $50 Visa gift card, so that can be used anywhere. So go click the subscribe button. You have nothing to lose and everything to win.
All righty. Again, on the Fox Stop scoreboard in the JV game, Yankton defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln 40-23. Kai Lily Medina had 10 points, 8 points for Kaylor Llewellyn, and Addie Skelhaas had 7 points. And in the sophomore game, or the C game, if you will, Sioux Falls Lincoln defeated Yankton 47-23. Coming up, we'll have the opening tip-off. This has been the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. We'll be back in 1 minute on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 and Five Star Streaming.
At Owen Family Dental Care, we see patients from 1 to 101.
Come experience our gentle touch while you relax in our massage chairs and watch TV. Patients are loving our new digital scanner. No more ooey, gooey, gaggy impressions.
We'd love to meet you, and we're always accepting new patients.
call 665-2530 to make an appointment. Elwood Family Dental Care, where we take care of the entire family.
At Explorers Credit Union,
Cornerstone Jewelry Design in Yankton's Meridian District is your local fine jewelry destination. We offer unique jewelry for every budget. Rings, earrings, necklaces, and bracelets, plus Landstrom's Black Hills Gold and our brand new selection of Seiko watches. Or we can custom design your perfect piece. We provide cleaning, inspection, and repairs, everything you need in a jewelry store, with the local values and service you love. For your milestones, count on Cornerstone. Stop and see us on 3rd Street or visit cornerstonejewelry.com.
All right, starting lineups being introduced here to the crowd at the Sioux Falls Lincoln Gym. Again, for Sioux Falls Lincoln, Sierra Velasquez, a 5'8 junior, and Kiara Lubavitch, a 5'10 sophomore at the forwards. The three-guard set of Addie Fawcett, a 5'8 senior, Charity Lemire, a 5'8 senior, and Mariah Syme, a 5'8 senior. The reserves, Caroline Hughes, a 5'4 junior, Madison Evans, a 5'5 junior, Megan Oshner, a 5'8 junior, and Ansley Futch, a 6' junior. Again, for the Yankton Gazelles, Cameron Kolecki, a 5'10 junior, Macy Drotzman, a 5'10 junior, at the forwards. The guards are Peyton Mosier, 5'5 junior, Claire Tereshinsky, a 5'5 junior, and Bailey LaCroix, a 5'6 junior. The reserves, Hattie Skelhaus, a 5'10 sophomore, Camilla Kopp, a 5'10 senior, Emma Herbold, a 5'8 junior, and Kai Lily Medina, a 5'9 junior. Jumping for Lincoln will be Lubavitch. Jumping for Yankton will be Macy Drotzman. And the tap is won by Yankton. Cameron Kolecki will get it out front. Here on the high post is Drotzman. Over to the left side to LaCroix. LaCroix over to the right to Mosier. And a pass inside to Drotzman. And our first foul of the game on Sioux Falls Lincoln, Kiara Lubavitch. Her first and the first team foul. Yankton will play it in on the end line. Yankton has it out front. Inside they go to Drotzman with the left hand. The shot is no good, but 3 seconds called before that. So Yankton, their first possession of the new basketball season, is a turnover. Here comes Lincoln, both teams playing man-to-man defensively. Here from the left corner, Lemire for a three, and it's no good. Rebound and a putback, no good by Fawcett. Fawcett gets the ball back and is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two with 7:17 left to go. First quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. No score in the Yankton foul on Cameron Kolecki, her first and the first team. So Fawcett at the line, a 5'8 senior, first of two, short. So still no score with 7:17 left to go in the first quarter. And the second on the way, good. So Sioux Falls Lincoln with an early 1-0 lead. Backcourt pressure, it goes into Tereshinsky, over to LaCroix, back to Claire. Claire across the timeline to Drotzman on the right side outside the arc. To LaCroix, to Tereshinsky. And now Sioux Falls Lincoln has switched to a zone and the Gazelles are trying to adjust. 15 left on the shot clock for the Gazelles on this, their second possession. Here's Tereshinsky, long three, off the back of the rim, no good. And the rebound to Lemire for Lincoln. Up ahead on the right side, here's Syme. Syme out front. To Fawcett, to Velasquez, and a pass to the left side to Lemire, knocked off the floor by Claire Tereshinsky. Lincoln will play it in with a 1-0 lead with 6:38 left to go, first quarter. Inbounds pass and a return pass. Now out front, here's Fawcett to reset the Lincoln offense. Fawcett on the high post to Velasquez. Here's Lubavitch. Lubavitch to the left side to Fawcett. And now Syme driving in. Shot from the left side of the lane is good. Mariah Syme gets the first field goal for either team, and it's 3-0 Lincoln. 6:13 left to go first quarter. For Yankton, driving in from the left and fouled is Cameron Kolecki. She'll shoot a pair. The Gazelles' first free throw attempts of the season. And the foul on Velasquez, her first, team second. So Yankton with a chance to get on the board. Cameron Kolecki from the line last year, as the first of two is good. Kolecki last year was 8 of 11 from the free throw line for 73%. So it's 3-1 Lincoln. 3-2 Lincoln as Kolecki gets them both. Back the other way for Lincoln. Here is Syme. Syme outside the arc on the right side. We played 2 minutes. Inside it goes to Lubavitch. And Lubavitch is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. Probably on a foul on Macy Drotzman. So Macy Drotzman will pick up her first, team second. So Kiara Lubavitch at the line for a pair. First of two is good. First substitute for Yankton is Emma Herbolt, the 5'8 junior. Coming out is Peyton Mosier. Trey Creer likes to rotate a lot of players in. Lubavitch with the second, short, battle for the rebound, and it comes to Syme. Syme on the right side, trying to get rid of LaCroix to the left side, to Lemire. Now here's Syme looking for a screen, gets it from Lubavitch. Here is Lubavitch on the high post, left side to Lemire, and traveling is called. On Lemire, it'll be Yankton basketball. 4-2 Sioux Falls Lincoln, 5:38 left to go first quarter. Gazelles looking for their first field goal of the season. Here's Tereshinsky over to LaCroix across the timeline to Drotzman on the right. Out front, Tereshinsky had the ball knocked away and a steal by Fawcett. Fawcett will bring it front court against the Yankton man-to-man. Right side, Syme. Syme with a bounce pass to Velasquez. Here on the drive, down low to Lubavitch, and the short shot off the grass is good. Lubavitch with her first field goal. She has 3 points. Yankton almost lost it in the backcourt. It's 6-2 Lincoln. 5 minutes to go first quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Here's a blocking foul on Lincoln's Charity Lemire, her first, team's third. As Lincoln will bring in Madison Evans, a 5'5 junior. And I think somebody else came in. Here is a three out front by Tereshinsky, no good. And the rebound to Ashley Thuch, who has checked in for the Patriots. 6-2 Lincoln, almost halfway through the first quarter already. For Lincoln, Syme, down low to Thuch, right side of the lane. Kicks it out front to Fawcett. Right side, Evans for a three, and the ball gets stuck between the backboard and the rim. So that means a jump ball. It'll go back to Lincoln with 19 to shoot. It is Lincoln's basketball. Yankton did win, Michael, the opening tip.
That they did.
And now Coach Matt Daly of Lincoln saying, hey, it's our ball.
Still need to get the ball out of the basket, though.
Well, nobody really tall enough, especially among the referees, to go up and get it. And now the ball dislodged, and we're ready to go. Again, Lincoln will inbound it on the end line with Fawcett to throw it in. And now a discussion. Well, they're going to reset the shot clock. All right. So it's just a change of possession. Lincoln with a new shot clock. Fawcett will get it into the right side to Hughes. Hughes to Syme. Syme will hand it off to Fawcett between the circles. To the right side to Evans. Evans bounce pass to Thuch. Foots looking back door will find Syme on the left. Syme, closely guarded by Tereshinsky, goes to Fawcett, guarded by LaCroix. Here's Syme, left baseline jumper is too strong. Battle for the rebound. Lincoln has it. Here's Fawcett for three, and it's no good. And the ball off the floor. Last touch by Mariah Syme of Lincoln. It'll be Yankton basketball. Macy Drotzman and LaCroix is back in. Camilla Kopp has snuck in for Yankton when we weren't looking. The only senior on the team, the 5'10 senior. 6'2 Lincoln, halfway through the first quarter. Here's Tereshinsky through the defense. Claire into the front court. Picked up out front by Caroline Hughes on the high post. Drotzman. Left side, LaCroix. In the corner, Peyton Mosher for three, and it's too long. Rebound to Syme. And Syme to Fawcett. Down low to Fuchs, who has trouble handling the ball. Gets it knocked away. And the steal to Camilla Kopp. Here's Tereshinsky. Had a dead-on three. Ball knocked away by Fawcett. Picked up by Mosher. Here's Bailey LaCroix setting up the offense near midcourt. 3:16 left to go first quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Lincoln 6, Yankton 2. Here's a give-and-go to LaCroix. Couldn't handle the basketball. Goes out of bounds to Lincoln. Back in for the Patriots is Velasquez. And coming out is Lubavitch. So 6-2 Lincoln. Inbounds pass goes to Addie Fawcett. Fawcett into the front court. We'll go to Velasquez. To Fuchs, again having trouble handling the ball and lost it out of bounds on the far sideline at midcourt. It'll be Gazelle basketball. And we haven't had a change in score, Michael, in about 2 or 3 minutes of game time here?
Yeah.
6-2 Yankton, or Yankton trailing Lincoln. 2:53 left to go, first quarter. Here is Tereshinsky. Gazelle still looking for their first field goal, and now a foul on Lincoln for a hold, and I think it's on Mariah Syme. Nope, it's on Velasquez. That's her second, team's fourth, and immediately Lubavitch comes in and replaces Velasquez, who hasn't scored in the game. 6-2 Sioux Falls Lincoln, 2:47 left to go, first quarter. Inbounds pass to Mosher, out front Tereshinsky, inside to Drotzman. Shot blocked, but a foul is called on Kiara Lubavitch. That's her second, and already the 15th foul on Sioux Falls Lincoln. Macy Drotzman at the line. Macy last year, a 72% free throw shooter, 26 of 36. As Cameron Kolevsky has the first 2 points for Yankton, let's see if Macy Drotzman can get 3 and 4, but the first of two here is no good. So no change in the score, 6-2 Lincoln, 2:43 left to go first quarter. And the second on the way is good. Second Yankton starter to score. Back in is Velasquez, and coming out is Ashley Fuchs. So Lincoln ball, Yankton with a little backcourt pressure, and Peyton Mosher will knock it away from Addie Fawcett. And now a stoppage of play. Terry Jastrom, one of our three officials, checking at the table. It goes into Syme. Syme picked up by LaCroix in the backcourt. Syme across the timeline. Hands it off to Fawcett. Fawcett from the left to the middle. Stops at the top of the key. Here is Madison Evans. And Madison Evans gets free. Great pass down low. Madison Evans makes it 8-3 in favor of Lincoln. 2:16 left to go first quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. And here is a foul or a timeout wanted by Yankton. So a 30-second timeout, 2:11 left to go first quarter. It's Lincoln 8, Yankton 3. back in 30 seconds on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and 5-star streaming.
Cremation is everything. This is Paul Wintz of the Wintz and Ray Funeral Home and Cremation Service in Yankton. Our family has been serving and helping families create memorable funeral experiences for nearly 75 years. You can put your trust in our experience and our guiding principle that we don't look at funeral service as just a job, but rather a way of life, an important ministry that our family is proud to provide. And we are thankful our reputation is one you can count on. Wintz and Ray Funeral Home, Yankton.
All right, 2:11 left to go. First quarter, the Yankton Gazelles take a 30-second timeout, the first timeout of the season. We're going to be hearing about a lot of firsts. Michael, the Gazelles still looking for their first field goal of the game.
That they are. Yeah, and they're 3 out of 4 from the line, which is good. But yeah, you'd like to hit. They haven't even really got that many shots off either.
No, they haven't. I can only think of maybe 2 or 3.
Yeah.
And one was a violation. Into the front court, LaCroix. Down low to Trotsman, and another turnover, and Trey Creer told me in the pregame, just got to keep the turnovers down, and Yankton turns it over again.
Yeah, you can't give free opportunities to your opponent, that's for sure.
1:58 left to go first quarter. Sioux Falls Lincoln 8, Yankton 3 in the season opener for both. Here's a backdoor play, a pass intended for Madison Evans, knocked off the floor by Evans. It was a great pass by Syme, but Yankton Gazelle kind of stepped in front of the pass, and it was deflected off the floor by the Patriots. Back the other way, here is Kolecki, who has a couple free throws in the game. And here's a steal by Syme, up ahead to Evans. Evans from the left side. She is fouled by Claire Tereshinsky. That is her first. Team's third. 1:34 left to go, first quarter. 8-3, Sioux Falls Lincoln. And Lincoln will bring in a couple after the first of two by Madison Evans, a 5'5 junior, has a bucket off the bench. And the first of two, no good. In for Lincoln is Megan Oshner, a 5'8 senior. One more Patriot at the bench. And the second by Evans is good. She has 3 off the bench. She'll come out. And back in is Charity Lemire. A zone press being put on by Sioux Falls Lincoln. Here is Tereshinsky to LaCroix. Back to Claire. Claire across the timeline. And a foul called on Lincoln. And it's on Charity Lemire. That is her second. Team 6, Yankton, with just 1:29 left to go first quarter, is a foul away from being in the bonus. But they are still looking for their first field goal of the season, trailing Lincoln 9-3. For the Gazelles, here's Mosier, left side to Kolecki, down low to Trotsman, in the lane, short jumper by LaCroix, won't get the roll. Rebound to Trotsman, puts it up, and that's no good. Gets it back again and is fouled and will shoot 2 with 1:15 left to go in the first quarter.
Well, they're getting some opportunities down close if they can just start to hit them.
Luvovich has just committed her third or second. I've got her for 3, and the first of 2 for Macy Drotzman is good.
And that is her third.
That is her third, yeah. So she will come out. And coming back in is Ashley Thuch. So 1:15 left to go, first quarter, 9-4 in favor of Sioux Falls Lincoln. And now a question at the table. Like I said, if the book has her for 3, that means she's got 3. I think Matt Daly of Lincoln is saying we're disputing that. Now Terry Chastrom talking with Coach Trey Creer and Assistant Coach Jill Muth about it. Jill is keeping a chart, and it must be fouls. or are they going to change it? Well, it's the first game for everybody, folks. 9-4, Sioux Falls Lincoln, 1:15 left to go in the first quarter. Now Terry Jastrom lets Brian Gary know what was discussed at the table. Macy Drotzman patiently waiting to shoot the second of two. All right. Looks like it's... Yep. So Macy can make it 9-5 with the second of two, and she does. 3 out of 4 from the line for the 5'10 junior. Lincoln leads Yankton 9-5, 1:12 left to go in the first half. For Lincoln, here is Syme from the right to the middle. Down low to Thuch, goes to the basket, just puts up a wild shot, and it's no good. Rebound Kalecki. Back the other way, Tereshinsky. Pass down low to Drotzman, knocked off the floor by Mariah Syme. And Bailey LaCroix underneath the Gazelle basket will throw it in. We're not harping on it, folks. We're just telling you, Yankton still looking for their first field goal of the season. A pass intended for Drotzman knocked away, taken by Mosier. Here's Tereshinsky over to Kalecki to the right side. Here down low to Macy Drotzman, and she'll lay it in for two. There we go. Macy Drotzman with 5 of Yankton's 7 points, their first field goal of the season. Here's a 3 right side by Madison Evans, no good, and the rebound in the corner to Peyton Mosier. Now under a minute to go, or under 30 seconds to go, shot clock is off. Yankton trailing 9-7. Boy, they could tie it or take the lead on their first 3 of the season. 15 seconds to go. Tereshinsky with it out front. Claire gets a screen from Drotzman, backs up, now drives in, and the layup is too strong. Rebound to Drotzman. Drotzman to LaCroix with 2 seconds left, and a tie-up with 0.5 to go. It'll go to Yankton with 0.5 left to go in the quarter. So can Yankton get a shot off in half a second? LaCroix to throw it in. Here is Kalecki. Oh, she should have shot it. She didn't have a chance. So after one quarter, and the season opener for both, Sioux Falls Lincoln 9, Yankton 7 on the Fox Top scoreboard. We'll be back in 1 minute with the second quarter on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 and 5-star streaming.
Seasons Power Sports in Yankton can help make your life easier and more fun. All Seasons Power Sports can help you with ATVs, side-by-sides, fishing and pleasure boats, as well as motorcycles, watercraft, and more. Check out their inventory at allseasonspowersportsinc.com. All Seasons Power Sports, your authorized Honda and Yamaha dealer, on your way to the lake in Yankton.
Cornerstone Jewelry Design, because...
because of the sense of community I felt ever since I first stepped on campus. I've been prepared for my career in nursing through the hands-on experience I get through classes and getting to start clinicals in my sophomore year. Here at MMU, there are countless things for you to do, whether you're on the sports team, in the theater program, or just hanging out with friends. When the weather's nice, my friends and I like to go out to the lake and go swimming, play some beach volleyball, or just hang out.
Come thrive with us at YanktonSD.com.
All right, start of the second quarter. Lincoln leads Yankton 9-7. Nice run by the Gazelles at the end of the first quarter. Lincoln with the ball first to start the second quarter. Here's a drive and a layup good by Addie Fawcett. She has 3, 11-7. Lincoln with 7:41 left to go in the first half on the Fox Top scoreboard. Here is Claire Tereshinsky for the Gazelles. Right side to Bailey LaCroix. Over to Peyton Mosier. Left side to Tereshinsky. And you can tell they're paying a lot of attention to her. Mariah Syme has her as a defensive assignment. Here is Tereshinsky for 3, and it's no good. Offensive rebound, Kalecki dribbles out. Gives to Tereshinsky, driving in, off the glass, and it's no good. Traveling is called. So traveling on Claire Tereshinsky of Yankton, 11-7 Lincoln, 7:09 left to go first half. Into the front court comes Addie Fawcett to Syme. Syme to the right side to Fawcett, driving in on Mosier. Here is Syme for a pull-up three, and it's good. Mariah Syme with the first three for either team. She has five. Just like that, a 5-0 run by Lincoln to start the second quarter. And it's 14-7 Lincoln with 6:45 left to go in the half. And Claire Tereshinsky has it knocked out of bounds in front of the Lincoln bench. Yankton will bring in Emma Herbold for Bailey LaCroix. And somebody else snuck in. I believe it was Kopp. Ball goes into the backcourt to Tereshinsky, which you can do. Claire across the timeline to the right side to Kolecki. Lincoln playing a 1-3-1 zone. Again, the Gazelles have been finding it tough. It goes inside to Drotzman. Jump hook is good. Macy Drotzman leads all scorers with seven, and it's 14-9. First bucket for the Gazelles in the second quarter. 6:15 left to go, first half. For Lincoln, Syme. Syme, another pull-up three, and it's an air ball. And knocked off the floor by Lincoln's Madison Evans. It'll belong to Yankton. Lincoln with a bucket by Fawcett and a three by Syme with a 5-0 run. But Macy Drotzman with her second field goal and the second field goal for the Gazelles. Yankton handling the pressure into the front court with Tereshinsky. Claire, right corner to Herbold, who had the ball knocked away. Here's a pass up ahead to Madison Evans, and Evans from behind, Peyton Mosier was giving her a little defensive pressure, and Evans turns it over. It goes back to Yankton.
They never stopped the clock on that one.
Well, little home cooking, huh?
Yeah.
Here's Macy Drotzman, who might have got away with a walk. Here is Tereshinsky on the right. It goes to Herbold. Herbold, her pass deflected, goes to Tereshinsky, who will bring it out front. Again, Lincoln playing his own. Inside it goes to Drotzman with four to shoot. Short shot, short, off the floor. Last touch by Emma Herbold. Yankton will bring back in Bailey LaCroix. And coming out is Peyton Mosier, who has scored in the game. Macy Drotzman with 7 points. Cameron Kolecki had the first points of the season for Yankton and a couple free throws in the first quarter. 5 minutes to go first half. Lincoln 14, Yankton 9. Down low, it goes to Lubavitch. Lubavitch from the left side. Can't get a shot to go, but she is fouled by Bailey LaCroix. Bailey with her first, team's fourth. And Lubavitch, one out of two from the line with 3 points, will shoot a pair for Lincoln. Lincoln led 9-7 after one quarter. First of two here is short. Back in for the Gazelles is Camilla Kopp. Coming out, Drotzman. Again, 7 out of the 9 Yankton points so far. No worries, folks. Thank you. And the second free throw is
also no good.
No good. Okay, so she's now 1 out of 4 from the line. Here's Fawcett out front for 3, no good. Battle for the rebound, Lubavitch has it. And now the ball knocked around and taken by Lincoln. Here from the right side is Velasquez, who's back in. Now to Mariah Syme. 14-9, Lincoln, 4:17 left to go in the first half. And here's a shot by Lincoln, short, and the rebound to Emma Herbold of Yankton. Back the other way is Tereshinsky. From the left side, here's Tereshinsky driving in. Puts up a wild shot, and it almost went. And a foul on the rebound on Emma Herbold. Emma will pick up her first and the 15 foul on Yankton. The So Yankton will bring back in two. Peyton Mosier is back in. And LaCroix is also back in. Have to bring the computer in a little bit, Michael. But, of course, when you're stomping up the bleachers, it's kind of easy to see while it fell off.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Here for Lincoln is Velasquez. The Fawcett left side to sign. Left side three is too strong. And the rebound to Macy Drotsman. Just ripped it away from Addie Fawcett. Still 14-9 Lincoln with 3:23 left to go first half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Out front, here's Kaletsky. Right side to LaCroix. Right corner to Tereshinsky. Here's a three by LaCroix that's short, and the rebound to Lubavitch. Up ahead, here on the left side is Syme. And it appears Yankton has now gone to his own. We try to pick it up. Both teams started man-to-man. Then Lincoln went to his own. Now Yankton is in a zone. Here at the free throw line, Velasquez, wide open three by Syme, and it's no good. Rebound to Cameron Kaletsky. 14-9, Lincoln with 2:38 left to go in the first quarter. Out front is Tereshinsky, who hasn't scored in the game. Again, averaged 10.3 for the Gazelles last year. Mosier to LaCroix, right side to Drotsman. Drotsman will get it out front to Tereshinsky. Claire backs up a three on the way, too strong, and the rebound to Madison Evans of Lincoln. And now a timeout wanted by Lincoln, a 30-second timeout. So with 2:09 left to go first half, it's Lincoln 14, Yankton 9 on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and Five Star Streaming will be back in 30 seconds.
Digital Solutions started small, but now we're growing as FDS provides live streaming coverage for over 20 schools across three different states on our Fuller Digital Solutions YouTube channel. Subscribe to get notified when we go live for your school events. Big events are captured live, and your business can get noticed with advertising during our live streams. Local talent and camera operators are encouraged to contact us too for future employment. No experience necessary. We will train. For information about advertising or working with Fuller Digital Solutions, email us and follow us on Facebook.
All right, Sioux Falls Lincoln and Matt Daly take a 30-second timeout. Lincoln 14, Yankton 9, 2:09 left to go in the first half. Lincoln on the far sideline will get it in to Fawcett. Fawcett will hand it off to Syme to Velasquez, to Syme on the right. Syme, a dribble between the legs, guarded by LaCroix, stays on the right, stops her dribble, gives to Velasquez driving in from the left, and the left-handed layup no good. Strong rebound by Macy Drotsman, who's back in for Yankton. So on the floor for Yankton is Mosier, Tereshinsky, Drotsman, LaCroix, and Kaletsky. Here is Drotsman with Thuch on her. Drotsman drives in the lane. Here's a three on the way by Mosier. That's short. Might have been deflected. Mosier gets the rebound back, drives in, and is fouled. And will go to the line to shoot two with 1:24 left to go in the first half. The foul on Velasquez is her third, team seventh. Correction, team's eighth. As Mosier is at the line for a pair in the first of two, no good. Peyton last year didn't try a free throw in varsity action. Lincoln makes a change. Lemire is back in. And the second of two by Peyton is good. Third Yankton starter to score, and it's 14-10, 1:21 left to go, first half. See if the Gazelles can get a good stop and a good set on offense here to come within a possession at halftime. Here is Fawcett in the lane. Right side to Madison Evans, and Madison Evans has 5 points off the bench for Lincoln. And the Patriots go back up by six, 16-10, under a minute to go in the first half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Left side, LaCroix, down low to Drotsman. Easy jumper, left baseline for two. Macy Drotsman with 9 to lead all scorers in the game. 16-12, Lincoln, 40 seconds left to go in the first half. For Lincoln, Evans has it knocked away by Tereshinsky. It comes to Fuch. Now to Evans on the right. 15 to shoot, 27 to play in the half. Syme, left side, a three by Lemire is good. Lemire with Lincoln's second three, fourth Lincoln starter to score. 19 to 12, 15 seconds, shot clock is off. Koletsky drives inside, reverse layup no good. Rebound to Lincoln with 7-6. Up ahead, driving in is Evans, left a layup short. Putback is no good. Another putback is no good. And a third putback is good by Lemire. And that's the end of the first half. So 5 straight points by Charity Lemire and Lincoln with their biggest lead at the half. It's Lincoln 21 and Yankton 12 after the Gazelles had come within 3 or 4 points late in the first half. Yankton High School basketball presented by First National Bank Omaha FNBO at the corner of 4th and Broadway Yankton. Full service banking, mortgage, ag, commercial, small business, free checking, savings and credit cards. Your great big small bank, FNBO, member FDIC. We'll be back with the Joe Dean's Halftime Show after this 2-minute timeout here on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570. KVTK.com and 5-star streaming.
Are you looking for the next great?
Nice.
Maytag appreciates a compliment, but this Maytag washer isn't just eye candy.
Wow.
Inside, it's got the capacity and power to handle even the mightiest loads.
I love this.
Yeah, she's a beaut.
It's a he.
How do you know?
Don't worry about it.
Find Maytag products and the industry's best appliances at your local dealer, Merce Appliance, downtown Vermilion.
A funeral home and cremation service in Yankton.
It's your invitation to thrive in Yankton, South Dakota. Nestled on the bluffs of the Missouri River, plenty of outdoor adventures are waiting. Whether you work remote or in a traditional office, we have a spot for you. Quality health care, diverse manufacturing, progressive school system, Mount Marty University, and so much more. Explore with family and friends. Let's thrive together.
Championship match, pinner competition.
Imagine working for a successful global business with customers in 140 countries. That's Fouché Intertechnology, a Fortune 1000 maker of electronic componentry. Now imagine a company of that size, with that kind of stability, and also a caring, family-like environment. Learn more about what you can do at Fouché by visiting www.fouchécareers.com. Fouché, the DNA of tech.
Better tendons, muscles, and ligaments.
New year, new flooring. I plan on saying hello with new flooring from Larson Carpet in Yankton. Larson Carpet will help with design and installation. They have a great selection of carpet, vinyl, luxury vinyl plank, hardwood, and tile. Stop in and let them help you get a new look in the new year. Larson Carpet at 208 Walnut Street in the Meridian District in Yankton. For the best flooring for your space, lifestyle, and budget, see Larson Carpet.
With Michael Schumacher, Joe Van Goor. Of course, tonight we're on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK.com, and 5-star streaming because of USD Women's Basketball on Classic Hits 106.3 and KVHTRadio.com. The Coyote women are in Greeley, Colorado, to face Northern Colorado at the half here at the Sioux Falls Lincoln Gym in the season opener for both. Sioux Falls Lincoln 21, Yankton 12. Michael Charity Lemire with a 5-0 run at the end of the first half to give Lincoln their biggest lead of the game.
Yeah, you know, somebody just looking at the score, it's a little deceiving because 9-7 after the first quarter with a very easy shot that could have tied it. And then, like you said, with about a minute and a half left, we're looking to keep it into a one-possession game. But, yeah, just that little spurt right there at the end made it all of a sudden now it's a 9-point game, and it looks much worse than the Gazelles have actually played. But we also mentioned they didn't score a ton from the field. A lot of it was from the free throw line. And so something's going to have to change, especially Claire Tereshinsky. She's going to have to get uncorked a little bit from the three-point line. That's going to be a big thing.
Yep, Claire Tereshinsky hasn't scored, and that's big for Yankton. Here's the first half scoring summary. Lincoln, four out of their five starters have scored, one off the bench, and showing balanced scoring. Mariah Syme has 5 points. Charity Lemire with five straight at the end of the first half has 5 points. Kiara Lubavitch and Addie Fawcett each with three. Kiara Velasquez started for Lincoln but hasn't scored. She, along with Lubavitch, have 3 fouls, and Lemire has 2. Madison Evans, well, I guess you could say kind of the difference for Lincoln in the first half. She has 5 off the bench. Megan Oshner and Ashley Tooch have played for Lincoln in the first half but haven't scored. Lincoln, 8 field goals, 2 of those 3-pointers, 1 by Simon, 1 by Lemire, and Lincoln, 3 out of 8 from the free throw line at the half. For Yankton, 3 out of their 5 starters have scored, none off the bench. Macy Drotzman with 9, Cameron Kolecki with 2, and Peyton Mosher with 1. Claire Tereshinsky and Bailey LaCroix started at guard for Yankton but hasn't scored. And off the bench, Camilla Kopp, Emma Herbold have played but haven't scored. The Gazelles with 3 field goals at the half, no 3-pointers, 6 out of 8 from the free throw line. Halftime is brought to you by Jodine's, the South Dakota tradition on North Broadway, Yankton, home of the $4.65 dinners to go every day with chicken, catfish, walleye, and shrimp. Grab a calendar of the month for more specials, seafood buffet every Friday and Saturday night, and open for the breakfast buffet on Sundays at 10:30 a.m. Call Jodine's at 665-9884 for your dinners to go. And our injury update is brought to you by Horizon Healthcare, keeping communities well throughout South Dakota with medical, dental, and behavioral health services. Horizon Healthcare, 920 Broadway, Yankton, is here for you and your family. And coming into the season opener, all the Gazelles healthy and ready to go. Let's take a 1 minute timeout. When we come back, we'll have Beyond the Game, and we'll bring you the fine arts calendar for the Yankton School District. We'll be back in 1 minute here at the Jodine's halftime. Lincoln 21, Yankton 12 on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and 5-star streaming.
Piper, the sign says it all, flowers and gifts. The store is bustling with something new all the time. There are flowers for any occasion, weddings, anniversary, birthday, or just to say I love you. There's coffee, soups, dips, and sweets. Need to give someone a chuckle? The socks say it all. Home decor, candles, jewelry, memorial items are all found at your gift store of Pied Piper Flowers and Gifts, corner of 15th and Broadway in Yankton. You can also shop online, and best of all, we deliver too.
Horizon Healthcare in Yankton offers medical, dental, and behavioral health services for all, from tooth pains to aches and pains. Our new location on 920 Broadway Avenue is a comfortable, expanded space where everyone is welcome. Whether insured, uninsured, Medicaid, or Medicare, here in Yankton, we care for all, and that's what we care about most. Call to schedule your appointment at Horizon Healthcare.
At halftime, on the Jodine's Halftime Show, Sioux Falls Lincoln 21, the Yankton Gazelles 12. Time for Beyond the Game, brought to you by the Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotel. Love, live, eat, stay, and have fun in a taste of times gone by at the Riverfront in the Meridian District, downtown Yankton. And checking the fine arts calendar for the Yankton School District, today and Saturday, Orlin Turp is at the Varsity State Tournament at Mitchell. Coming up Monday is the Middle School Band Holiday Concert, 7 o'clock at the South Gym at Yankton Middle School. Next Thursday, the Lincoln Elementary Vocal Concert, grades 1 through 3, at the main theater at the Yankton High School Summit Activities Center at 7 o'clock. And then, a week from tomorrow night, on Saturday, December 10th, the high school winter semi-formal dance at 7:30 at the Yankton High School Summit Activity Center. And that is the Fine Arts Calendar and Beyond the Game, brought to you by the Riverfront and Brewery Event Center in the Meridian District in downtown Yankton. All right, just about ready to start the third quarter of action. Again, Sioux Falls Lincoln leading 21-12. Now, folks, let's hear from our Beyond the Game sponsor back in 30 seconds here on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and 5-star streaming.
Ready to make your mouth water? Just look at the screen. That's Bro Burger Bar, 304 West 3rd Street, Yankton.
All right. Again, on the Fox Stop scoreboard in the sub-varsity games, the Yankton JVs defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln 40-23. Kai Lilly Medina led with 10 points. And in the sophomore game, Sioux Falls Lincoln 47, Yankton 23. Halftime brought to you by Jodine's, the South Dakota tradition on North Broadway, Yankton. Yankton will have the ball first to start the third quarter. Cameron Kaletsky, Macy Drotzman, Peyton Mosher, Claire Tereshinsky, and Bailey LaCroix. For Lincoln, their original starting five of Kiara Velasquez, Kiara Lubavitch, Addie Fawcett, Charity Lemire, and Mariah Syme. And Terry Jastrom at the scorer's table, making sure things are copacetic. Heading into the third quarter, the Gazelles will host Huron in ESD action next Tuesday night at the Yankton High School Summit Activity Center gym at 7 o'clock. And that game on Tuesday night, fans, will be on 5-star streaming only because of USD men's basketball on Classic Hits 106.3 and USD women's basketball on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570. Then a week from tonight, will be just down the road in Harrisburg for an ESD doubleheader, the Yankton girls and the Harrisburg girls, followed by the Yankton Bucks and their opener against the Harrisburg Tigers. And that will be on 5-star communications and 5-star streaming. It might be that the scoreboard is stuck, Michael.
That's what I'm wondering. This is an odd delay.
Yeah. Now it's ready to go. Like I said, it's the first game for everyone. And the inbounds pass goes to Peyton Mosher, and the third quarter is underway. Here's Tereshinsky over to Mosher. Lincoln still in that zone. They started man-to-man. Here's LaCroix for three, and it's too strong. Rebound to Velasquez for Lincoln. Again, Lincoln starting with a 21-12 lead here in the third quarter. Here's their first possession. Here down low is Syme, goes around Kaletsky, and the layup is good. Mariah Syme now with seven, and Lincoln on a 7-0 run. Leads 23-12 with 7:21 left to go in the third quarter. For Yankton, right corner Mosher goes to Tereshinsky. Claire backs up, jumper just inside the ring is no good. Rebound to Trotsman. Macy will kick it out to Tereshinsky. A runner in the lane off the glass is good. The bank is open, and Claire Tereshinsky finally gets on the scoreboard as that ends a Lincoln 7-0 run from the end of the second quarter. It's 23-14, and LaCroix causes a turnover. Lubavitch lost it off her thigh, and it belongs to Yankton. With 6:48 left to go, third quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Lincoln 23, Yankton 14.
Well, that's the kind of stop they need. You know, get back from under nine now, down to seven or six.
Tereshinsky drives in the lane. Free throw line jumper is short. and the rebound to Lemire. Into the front court, right side is Syme. Syme drives in the lane. Short jumper, good. Mariah Syme with nine now to lead Lincoln. 25-14, 6:24 left to go, third quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. For Yankton, Macy Trotzman will give it in the middle to Tereshinsky. LaCroix over to Cameron Kolecki for three. No good. Rebound, a battle for it. Macy Trotzman was battling Lemire for it, and it's off Lemire. It'll belong to the Gazelles. LaCroix will inbound it on the end line. Lincoln zones the out-of-bounds play, and, of course, they're still in that zone. Here is Peyton Mosier, right side to Bailey LaCroix, down low to Trotzman, right baseline. Here driving in, a runner by Tereshinsky off the glass, too strong in the rebound to Velasquez. Up ahead to Fawcett, right side to Syme. Tereshinsky comes up on her. Out front to Fawcett. Gazelle staying man-to-man. They did play a little zone in the second quarter. Down low to Syme. Here is Lubavitch with a baseline jumper, no good. And the ball trying to be saved off the floor by Velasquez. And it will belong to Yankton. Back in for Yankton is Camilla Kopp. Macy Drotzman will get a rest. Macy leading Yankton with 9 points. Here is Tereshinsky. Claire through the defense. Left corner will go to Kolecki, to Mosier. Out front to Tereshinsky. Doubled up out front. Lost the ball. And it's taken away by Addie Fawcett. Fawcett, down low, wide open. And not able to complete the layup was Velasquez, but she's fouled and will shoot two with 5:08 left to go in the third quarter. Peyton Mosier will pick up her first and her second. Nope, it's not Velasquez. It's Lemire at the line. Again, she had a little 5-0 run at the end of the first half to give Lincoln a 21-12 halftime lead. 25-14, biggest lead for Lincoln. And now all of a sudden the clock has reset to 8 minutes. So Lemire will be at the line. Lincoln was 3 out of 8 from the line in the first half, while Yankton was 6 out of 8. So Lincoln so far in this third quarter has scored 4 points. The Gazelles have scored 2. And again, Claire Tereshinsky of Yankton finally getting on the scoreboard.
Yeah, she is such a big part of this offense, and her just not hitting. She's had a few chances from the outside, but hasn't been able to hit. Same with Bailey LaCroix. If either one of them could start hitting from the outside, it would really open things up for this team.
Little excitement on the far sideline. Now coming to our side. How about a Lincoln basketball T-shirt, huh? No, Michael.
Oh, man.
Don't worry about it.
But I want a T-shirt.
5:30 left to go is the time left in the third quarter. And
well, again,
yeah. Lemire was ready to go, shooting free throws, and cheerleaders were still out on the floor chucking T-shirts.
It's like a Globetrotters game.
Yeah, kind of, yeah. Oh, yeah. Remember watching the Harlem Globetrotters on Wide World of Sports?
Oh, yeah.
Curly Neal.
Curly Neal was the best.
Meadowlark Lemon.
Yep.
Oh, those are the two I remember. All right, now Lemire at the line. And the first of two is no good. Lincoln now 3 of 9 from the line for 33%. And the second on the way, good. She has 6. And Lincoln building on their biggest lead. It's now 12 at 26-14. And Yankton has the ball knocked away on the far sideline by Lemire on the right side of that zone on the far sideline. It will be LaCroix to get it in to Claire Tereshinsky. Claire to the left side to Mosier. Back to Claire. Claire inside the top of the key to LaCroix. Now to Tereshinsky. Lost the ball, taken by Lemire. A one-on-two break, and Kaletsky will step in front of a pass intended for Mariah Syme, and back the other way comes Yankton. Yankton with only 2 points this quarter, while Lincoln has five, and Lincoln with a 12-point lead. Tereshinsky backs up. Shot inside the lane is no, or inside the circle is no good, and the rebound to Lincoln. Here is Fawcett to Syme for a three, and it's short. Rebound Kaletsky. Cameron's had a few rebounds tonight for the Gazelles. Coming up on the midway point of the third quarter. Driving in, great move by Peyton Mosier. And Peyton Mosier will get a bucket to go. And a timeout Yankton, a full timeout. But let's take a 30-second timeout. With 4:28 left to go in the third quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard, Sioux Falls Lincoln 26, Yankton 16. Back in 30 seconds on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KBTK Vermilion Yankton, and 5-star streaming.
Don't let the name fool you. Rexall Drug isn't just a drugstore. I mean, yes, it is a drugstore that can help with your pharmacy needs, but it also has more. Hallmark gift cards and many more gifts to select from throughout the store, including a kids section. But my favorite is the selection of chocolates at the front. It's not just a drugstore, it's Yankton Rexall.
All right, Yankton, after a bucket by Peyton Mosier, who has 3 points, Claire Tereshinsky has the other bucket for Yankton. Lincoln has outscored Yankton 5-4 here in the third quarter, but the Gazelles trail by 10, 26-16, with 4:28 left to go in the third quarter. So Yankton now with a 30-second timeout, two fulls. Matt Daly of Sioux Falls Lincoln has a 30 and three full timeouts. And it's Lincoln basketball. In the front court, on the right side, Madison Evans is back in. Evans tried to go down low, and it's knocked away by Drotzman and taken by Peyton Mosier. That pass was intended for Lubavitch. Here's Bailey LaCroix, double dribble, and it'll be Lincoln basketball. Almost halfway through the third quarter, 26-16. Sioux Falls Lincoln over Yankton. Season opener for both on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Here's Madison Evans. Evans to Lubavitch. Down low, wide open, Mariah Syme, but she missed the layup, and the rebound knocked off the floor by Yankton. Emma Herbold is checked back in for Yankton. Bailey LaCroix. Nope, Claire Tereshinsky will check back in, and Peyton Mosier out. 26-16 Lincoln. 3:50 left to go in the third. On the end line, Fawcett, left corner, goes to Evans, who missed a long shot, and the foul on the rebound on Lincoln.
The foul is on Syme.
Mariah Syme will pick up her first, team's first, this half. Coming out for the Gazelles is Kopp. And back in is Macy Drotzman. So it's a seven-player rotation for Trey Creer and the Gazelles. Right side, here's Tereshinsky driving in. We'll dribble back out to the three-point line. Here's Herbold to LaCroix. Down low to Drotzman. Drotzman in traffic, off the glass too strong. Rebound comes to Drotzman. Ball knocked off the floor, blocked from behind by Velasquez. It'll be Yankton basketball with a near new shot clock, trailing 26-16. 3:17 left to go in the third. LaCroix will get it into Drotzman. Out front to Tereshinsky. Claire on the drive and fouled. will go to the line to shoot two with 3:13 left to go third quarter. So the foul on Addie Fawcett, her first, team second. Claire Tereshinsky with a bucket this quarter, her first points of the season. Claire from the free throw line was 29 of 45 last season, 64%, and misses the first of two. Second on the way, that's no good. Those are the first attempts for the Gazelles in this half. They're now 6 of 10 from the line after being 6 of 8 in the first half. Lincoln by 10 with the ball. Down low, Syme. Syme on the block. Here's a jumper. That is an air ball out of bounds by Velasquez, and it goes to Yankton. Now under 3 minutes to go, third quarter. And Lincoln still with a 26-16 lead. Under some backcourt pressure, here's Tereshinsky up ahead to Kaletsky, to Trotsman, now to Tereshinsky. Claire being hassled out front by that Lincoln zone on the end line. Trotsman will try to get it to LaCroix left baseline, knocked off the floor by the Patriots. Peyton Mosier back in for Yankton. Back in for Lincoln is Charity Lemire. Again, Lemire with a 5-0 run at the end of the half to give Lincoln a 21-12 halftime lead. The lead has been as big as 12. When it was 26-14, it's 26-16, 2:39 left to go in the third. Claire for three, and it's no good. And back the other way comes Lincoln with Addie Fawcett. Fawcett lost the ball. Gives it to Fawcett. Right side, I should say, to Madison Evans. And Evans throws the ball away right into the hands of Tereshinsky. Two-on-three break. Tereshinsky trying to draw a foul. Lost the ball back the other way. Mariah Syme. Syme will bounce it out front to Evans. To Fawcett, back to Evans, and the layup good. Evans with 7 points off the bench. She is the only player for either team to score off the bench. Back up to a 12-point lead, and here's carrying the basketball on Yankton's Cameron Kaletsky. Back in is Emma Herbold and Peyton Mosier. So Lincoln with the basketball and a 12-point lead with 1:44 left to go in the third quarter. Here's another backdoor play to Evans, but Evans trying to save it, threw it into the hands of Kaletsky. Yankton still looking for their first three-pointer of the game and of the season, trailing by 12. Here's LaCroix to Mosier. Claire Tereshinsky taking an end-of-the-quarter break. Here's Herbolt. Here's a long three by LaCroix, short. Herbolt had the rebound in her hands, and back the other way comes Lincoln. Syme for three, right side, and it is no good. It wouldn't stay. And now coming up on a minute to go in the third, LaCroix has the ball knocked away from behind by Fawcett, and a timeout to Sioux Falls Lincoln to save possession. Second, 30-second timeout with 1:01 left to go in the third quarter. Lincoln 28 and Yankton 16. We'll be back in 30 seconds here on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and 5-star streaming.
Are you looking for the next great career opportunity? Then make it Sherco, a staple of the Yankton community for nearly 30 years. Sherco offers career opportunities in engineering, sales, marketing, accounting, tarp and metal fabrication, shipping, and more. Enjoy a year-round climate-controlled facility, 401k options, affordable health, dental, and vision care, paid time off, and 10 paid holidays. Make Sherco your next great opportunity. Learn more at sherco.com/careers.
.101 left to go in the third quarter. After a timeout by Lincoln to save a possession, it'll be Lincoln basketball on the end line, leading by 12, their biggest lead, 28-16. On the end line, Fawcett will throw it into Syme on the left. Now back to Fawcett, who will bring it out front to reset. the Patriots offense. Right side to Lemire. Pass down low to Syme. And a foul called on Peyton Mosier for trying to get a steal. Mosier with her second, team second. On the end line, Fawcett again to throw it in for Lincoln. It'll go in to Syme. Ball knocked away. Peyton Mosier trying to get it, and I think Syme just gave her a playful little hip to get her out of the way. Here's Syme on the right side with 30 seconds. Little runner in the lane, no good. Rebound to Macy Drotzman. Macy will clear and give it to Claire Tereshinsky, who's back in. Probably about half a second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Yankton would love to get this back down to 10, 9 if possible, on their first three of the night. Here's Tereshinsky driving in. The runner off the glass, too strong. Rebound to Trotsman. Trotsman up and blocked by Lubavitch. Back the other way, Lincoln with 4, 3, Syme. Here driving in is Lemire, and she scores just ahead of the bucker. Charity Lemire with 8 points, and Lincoln with a 30-16 lead over Yankton. Heading into quarter number 4, let's take a 1-minute timeout here on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 and 5-star streaming.
For 75 years servicing Northeast Nebraska, Elkhorn Valley Bank and Trust has crossed the river and is excited to announce the opening of a new Yankton branch.
I'm Glenn Peterson, Market President. While Elkhorn Valley Bank might be new to Yankton, our staff has years of banking experience in the Yankton area. Our focus is on our customers and the communities in which they live. We look forward to serving you and giving back to Yankton and the surrounding communities. We invite you to come see that at Elkhorn Valley Bank, there really is a difference.
Member FDIC.
All Seasons Power Sports
Oasis in Yankton is your one stop for everything you need convenience store. Before the road trip, stop and pick up your snacks. Lots of 2-for-the-price-of-1 items. For breakfast, lunch, and dinner, JR's has tasty get-and-go food for you. JR's always offers 99-cent fountain drinks, too. Don't forget to fill up the tank with Phillips 66 fuel. Use your Phillips 66 card for gas savings, too. JR's Oasis wish the best to the Bucks and Gazelles this year. JR's Oasis, Highway 50 East in Yankton.
All right, 8 more minutes to go from the Sioux Falls Lincoln gym in the season opener for both. Sioux Falls Lincoln outscores Yankton 9-4 in the third quarter and has their biggest lead of 14, 30-16. Lincoln basketball to start the fourth and final frame. Here is Syme on the left. Out front, Fawcett for a three, and it's no good. Rebound will come to Syme, and Syme will put it back in for two more. She is the first player for either team in double figures with 11. Now 32-16, Lincoln has doubled up Yankton with 7:34 to go. Inside it goes to Kolecki, off the glass too strong. Yankton has had some good looks inside, just can't get them to go. Back the other way, Lincoln. Here's Syme, little short jumper is good. Four straight by Syme. She has 13, and now Lincoln with some distance between them and the Gazelles, 34-16, about a minute gone in the fourth quarter. Here is LaCroix having trouble with the ball. Syme got the steal, but she was out of bounds on the far sideline. It'll go back to Yankton. Again, Lincoln with some backcourt pressure virtually all night long. It goes into the front court to Drotzman. Drotzman, and here's the steal by Syme. Syme will hand it over to Madison Evans, who is fouled by Bailey LaCroix and will shoot two. Bailey with her second, team's third. Evans, 1 out of 2 from the line, with 7 points off the Lincoln bench. Lincoln as a team, as the first of two for Evans is good. She's got 8. Back in for Yankton is Camilla Kopp. Macy Drotzman, who had 9 first half points, hasn't scored yet in the second half. The second by Evans on the way, good. Lincoln, 3 out of 4 from the line in the second half after going just 3-for-8 in the first half. And now Lincoln by 20 on a little run with 6:46 to go. Here in the right corner is Kopp. Here's a jumper good by Bailey LaCroix, and a timeout wanted by Yankton. Bailey LaCroix is the fifth Yankton starter to score. Yankton will take its second 30-second timeout, and Michael and I will take it with him. 6:35 to go. It's Sioux Falls Lincoln 36, Yankton 18, back in 30 seconds on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and five-star streaming.
Jack out of Jodine's, and we've got a lot to talk about, so crank up that radio, sit tight, and don't miss a minute. We've got the seafood buffet every Friday and Saturday. We've got steaks, burgers, chicken to go. There's pizza, fresh baked chocolate chip cookies on the buffet Monday through Thursday. And don't forget about the 465 dinners to go. When you're in a hurry, just give us a call, stop in, we'll have them ready for you. We'll do the cooking for you. 2809 Broadway, Yankton.
Jodine's Restaurant, a South Dakota tradition.
All right, after a Yankton 30-second timeout, they have two fulls left, no 30s. Lincoln with three fulls and no 30s. 36-18. Lincoln with 6:26 left to go. After a bucket by Bailey LaCroix, here's a three right side by Syme, no good. Put back by Lubavitch, no good. Rebound tip to Fawcett. That one is short. And back the other way, Bailey LaCroix for Yankton. Bailey stopped. Goes to Tereshinsky. Jumper inside the ring is short. Rebound to Lubavitch. Back the other way to Mariah Syme. Left side, a three off the mark by Velasquez. Back the other way, Yankton. Now Claire will slow up. Left side will give to Kolecki, to Tereshinsky. Pass down low to Cameron Kolecki. Knocked off the floor by Madison Evans. Mosier and Herbold back in for Yankton. Ashley Thuch, who played a little in the first half, and I believe in the third quarter as well, is back in for Lincoln. 36-18 Lincoln, 5:45 to go. Yankton with the ball underneath their own basket. It goes into Herbold. Out front, Tereshinsky. Inside to Macy Drotzman. Drotzman can't find anything around Lubavitch. Falls to the floor. Here's Tereshinsky with it. It goes out front. Here's a drive by Peyton Mosier. Can't finish the layup, but was fouled. And we'll shoot two with 5:30 to go.
The foul is on Lemire.
Charity Lemire with her third team. So Peyton Mosier, one out of two from the line with 3 points, shooting two. First of two, no good. And now Yankton is 0 for 3 from the line in the second half after going 6 of 8 in the first half. 36-18 Lincoln, 5:30 to go. Coming up, the First Dakota National Bank Gazelle basketball postgame show. Second by Mosier is no good, and back the other way comes Lincoln. Out front, Addie Fawcett looking back door will find Syme near the near sideline. Here's Thuch. Thuch with a pass to the left side to Fawcett. Pass down low, intended for Lubavitch, taken away by Camilla Kopp. Back the other way, Herbold on the left. Herbold will bring it toward the middle. Right side to Drotzman. Drotzman will give it left side to Herbold. Now Mosier to Tereshinsky. Tereshinsky trying to drive in, puts up a wild shot that was partially deflected, and Lincoln comes the other way. Here is Lemire to Syme. Syme to Addie Fawcett. Yankton sticking with the man-to-man defense. They did play a little zone in the second quarter. Here is Lubavitch inside to Thuch. Ball knocked away by Camilla Kopp, taken by the Gazelles. We're almost halfway through the fourth quarter with Yankton trailing 36-18. The Gazelles with the ball. And ball knocked away from Emma Herbold out of bounds. Yankton will play it in. Coming in, Cameron Kolecki, Coming out for Yankton, Camilla Kopp and Tara Shimsky. It goes in the backcourt to Mosier, who will play the point with Tara Shimsky out. Lincoln staying with that zone. They've really spread out the Gazelles. It goes inside to LaCroix and a foul, I believe, on Lemire. Lemire with her fourth, team's fourth. Caroline Hughes, a 5'4 junior, sees her first action of the season coming in for Addie Fawcett. 36-18 Lincoln, 3:52 to go. Yankton will inbound it on the end line. Lob pass goes to the right to Herbold. Inside, Macy Drotzman will get free and scores her first points of the second half. She's the first Gazelle in double figures with 11. 36-20 with 3:40 to go. Lincoln will try to run some time down, running their offense. Here's Hughes on the right being hassled by Peyton Mosier. It goes to Lemire. Lemire looking for Thuch. We'll get it to Lubavitch, who can't find the handle and goes into the backcourt and is called for over and back. Yankton basketball with 3:20 to go. And now over and back called on Bailey LaCroix after the inbounds pass. Trey Creer going, no. She didn't establish front court status yet. She did have a foot over the line, and there was a foot back in the backcourt, and Trey Creer just smiling. 3:17 to go. Yankton trailing. Lincoln with the ball. In for Lincoln is Megan Oshner. Oshner with it on the right side. Pass deflected away. A steal by LaCroix, who saves it from going out of bounds. A scramble for it, and a tie-up. It'll go to Yankton with 3:01 to go. Yankton with 4 points so far this quarter. Lincoln has six, but Lincoln, after a 9-7 first quarter lead, had a 9-point lead at the half on a 5-0 run by Charity Lemire, and then outscored the Gazelles 9-4 in the third quarter to lead 30-16, 36-20, Lincoln with 2:45 to go. Here driving in, a layup too strong, and a putback up and good. And Emma Herbel will get the first bench points for Yankton. 36-22 Lincoln with 2:26 to go. So the Gazelles, after trailing by 20, have it down to 14 with 2:19 to go, but time is not on their side. Here's Lubavitch. Driving the baseline is Lemire. Oh, she got away with a walk but was fouled. Maybe the reason why she walked is she was fouled. And the foul on Emma Herbold. That is her second. And the fourth team foul. Yankton will bring back in Claire Tereshinsky and Camilla Kopp. Lincoln will inbound it on the end line. With 2:11 to go and Lincoln leading 36-22. For Lincoln, this is Caroline Hughes. Hughes will go back door to Lemire. Reverse layup try, no good. Rebound, Claire Tereshinsky with 1:55 to go. Up ahead to Mosier. A breakaway layup hits the bottom of the backboard and rebounded by Lincoln with 1:47 to go. And it's 36-22. Lemire moving in from the left. Missed the layup completely in the rebound to Tereshinsky. 1:37 to play. 36-22 Lincoln. Here's Tereshinsky. Left baseline jumper too strong. It didn't draw iron in the rebound to Lemire. No correction to Megan Oshner. Here's Hughes out front to Lebovich. To Fuch. Fuch. Right corner, here's Lemire for a three, and it's no good. It hit the side of the backboard, and now coming up on a minute to go, and Sioux Falls Lincoln will pick up a season-opening victory over Yankton. the third straight victory for Sioux Falls Lincoln since we came back and did the Gazelles. Claire Tereshinsky missed the layup inside. Again, the Gazelles have had some great looks inside, Michael. Just can't convert as Lincoln turns it over. Yankton plays it in with 47 seconds to play.
Yeah, they really have. When they look at the game tape, they're going to realize they had a number of close-in shots. Now, I know you can be off from the outside, but close-in shots that get a few of those to drop, and it's a much different game.
Yep. All right, so the Gazelles trailing 36-22. They did trail by 20. So 25 to shoot, 36 seconds to play. Here's Macy Drotzman to beyond the free throw line, right side to Peyton Mosier. Down low to Kolecki, double team, got in between, missed it, got her own rebound back. But it didn't touch the rim, so now 10 seconds to shoot. Here's a pass inside to Emma Herbold, and a foul on Lincoln with 20.8 left to go in the game. Shot clock is off. Lubavitch will commit her fourth, team's fifth, and in for Lincoln. As the inbounds pass goes to Drotzman. Looks like Delaney Downham, a freshman, is in with 10 seconds to play. Driving in is Herbolt. The layup no good. Rebound tip to Drotzman with 3 seconds left. Drotzman in the left corner can't get a shot off, and that is the end of the game. Sioux Falls Lincoln 36, Yankton 22 in the season opener for both. With the win, Lincoln goes to 1-0. They will play one of the top favorites in AA girls basketball, Sioux Falls Washington, coming up next Thursday. Yankton will be playing at Huron. No, at home against Huron next Tuesday night, the Yankton High School Summit Activities Center gym. And that game next Tuesday, folks, is on five-star streaming only because of USD men's basketball on Classic Hits 106.3 and USD women's basketball on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570. I guess there will be a quiz later. All right, Yankton High School basketball presented by First National Bank Omaha, FNBO, at the corner of 4th and Broadway in Yankton. Full-service banking, mortgage, ag, commercial, small business, free checking, savings, and credit cards. Your great big small bank, FNBO, member FDIC. The First Dakota National Bank Gazelle basketball postgame show coming up after this two-minute timeout here on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570.
Or your vehicle running low on fuel? Stop into Triple Time Rudy's, 17th and Broadway Yankton, or Gerstner Oil at East Highway 50 Yankton and refuel on gasoline, snacks, and beverages. Both stores are locally owned and operated and offering pay at the pump or 5 cents per gallon discount for cash. Gerstner Oil Company supplies bulk fuel and lubricants for your farm or business. Call 605-665-5568 for a quote. Gerstner Oil is a proud local sponsor of this sports broadcast.
Your number one Yankton High School fans.
Floor is wet, the air ducts are nasty, you can smell mold, you have had a fire, or you need the carpets cleaned, you know you can call FloorTech Cleaning and Restoration in Yankton to do any one of those jobs. FloorTech Cleaning and Restoration, with 24-hour emergency services in Yankton, Norfolk, Northeast Nebraska, and Mitchell. When the floor is wet, call FloorTech Cleaning and Restoration, now located at 220 East 3rd Street in Yankton.
We are your full-service florist and gift center. Stunning fresh.
Oba's Agency, in partnership with Colonial Life, a partnership to help your business grow and protect you when the unexpected happens. Service second to none. Willing to take the extra steps to make sure you have a partner to help you through the claims process. Increased employee retention and attracting quality talent. That's the reason you would offer voluntary benefits, which are supplements to major medical through Antrobus Agency. A family business to help your family and employees. Antrobus Agency.
Star company with the highest Energy Star rated geothermal systems.
Chef Rico from Willoughby's Bistro and Emporium welcomes you to experience their homemade cuisine, friendly atmosphere, coffee, and culture in the downtown Meridian District. try a panini or a cup of homemade soup for lunch, and for dinner, try a plate of her homemade pasta or a pan-fried steak. This all happens Tuesday through Saturday at Willoughby's in the Meridian District in downtown Yankton.
Wait a minute, you said Chef Rika?
Chef Rika. That's what we all call her.
She's not a cook, she's a chef.
Michael Schumacher, Jovan Goor, and in the season opener for both teams to open up girls basketball in 2022-2023. It is the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots 36, the Yankton Gazelles 22. It's time for the First Dakota National Bank Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show, brought to you by First Dakota National Bank. First Dakota has proudly supported the dreams and banking needs of our customers for 150 years. They offer personal, business, and ag banking solutions for every stage of your journey with two locations, downtown and North Broadway in Yankton. Well, Sioux Falls Lincoln led 9-7 after one quarter, increased that lead to 21-12 at the half. Charity Lemire, the 5'8 senior guard, had five straight points at the end of the half to give Lincoln a nine-point lead. And then Lincoln led 30-16 after three quarters as Lincoln scored 9 points and the Gazelles 4 points in the third quarter. Lincoln got the lead up to 20, but the Gazelles got it down to 14. And again, the final score, 36 for Sioux Falls Lincoln. Yankton with 22 here on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Let's give you tonight's scoring summary. First of all, for Sioux Falls Lincoln, four out of their five starters score, one off the bench. Mariah Syme had 13 points, eight for Charity Lemire, three apiece for Addie Fawcett and Kiara Lubovich. Kiara Vasquez started for Lincoln, didn't score. As a matter of fact, Lubovich and Velasquez were in foul trouble all night long, as was Charity Lemire, who ended up with four fouls, Lubovich with four fouls, and Velasquez with three, but Yankton or Lincoln never got into the bonus in tonight's game. Madison Evans off the bench had 9 points. Caroline Hughes, Megan Oshner, and Ashley Thuch all played for Lincoln but didn't score. Lincoln 14 field goals, two of those three-pointers, both in the second quarter, one by Syme and one by Lemire. And after Lincoln was just 3 of 8 from the line in the first half, they were 3 out of 4 in the second half and finished at 50%, 6 out of 12. For Yankton, all five starters score, one off the bench, one in double figures. Macy Drotzman led the way with 11, 3 points for Peyton Mosier, two apiece for Cameron Kaletsky, Claire Tereshinsky, and Bailey LaCroix. Off the bench, Emma Herbold had two. Camilla Kopp also played for the Gazelles tonight but didn't score. The Gazelles with 8 field goals, no three-pointers. They were 6 of 8 from the free throw line in the first half, but 0 of 4 in the second. So they end up at 50% at 6 out of 12. And again, the final score is Sioux Falls Lincoln 36 and Yankton 22. This is the Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show, brought to you by First Dakota National Bank. We'll be back with more after this 3-minute timeout at Gazelle Basketball on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 and 5-star streaming.
Carpet Center.
Stewart Carpet Center?
Stewart Carpet Center, since 1958.
That's a long time.
Since 1958, Stewart Carpet Center has been covering the area with quality flooring. Carpet, vinyl, laminate, hardwood, tile, every floor, everywhere.
You can depend on Stewart Carpet Center, located on Broadway.
1803 Broadway, Yankton.
Contact Stewart Carpet Center for your flooring solutions.
Website is stewartcarpetcenter.com.
Yankton Medical Clinic is proud of
Lotus Soaps and Company, located at 215 West 3rd Street, Yankton, has naturally handmade soaps, sugar scrubs, lotions, shampoos, conditioners, and so much more. Shop at the Lotus Soaps and Company in Yankton today to find your healthy, hand-poured essentials for your skin. New items are made regularly. Lotus Soaps and Company in Yankton even takes custom orders. Give Tonya a shout at Lotus Soaps and Company. Gifts for all occasions.
One Fuel, 7 to Triple Time Rudy, 17th Broadway, Yankton, or Gerser Oil.
simple sniffles to complex health conditions, the primary care providers at Yankton Medical Clinic will not only see you for your annual visits, screenings, and preventative care, but also provides care for the entire family, from pediatrics to adults. With 4 clinic locations and 15 outreach locations throughout South Dakota and Nebraska, compassionate, quality medical care is closer than you think. For more information on providers, services, and locations, visit our website, yanktonmedicalclinic.com.
Our store, helping my customers with our free interior design service is still my
perfect night of sleep can be found with Slumberland Sleep Solutions Center. Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, and Sealy all feature. Don't lose another night of sleep. Stop by Slumberland of Yankton.
Looking to update the family room? Look no further than Yankton Slumberland. Lazy Boy, Flex Steel Furniture, and more. All at your hometown furniture store. That's Slumberland of Yankton.
Carpet, vinyl, laminate, hardwood.
Your heating and cooling values reliability as much as you do. That's why Kaiser Heating and Cooling creates and maintains their own product. They have the skills to create and help solve any problems that may come up. Kaiser Heating and Cooling also has Heat and Glow and Dimplex fireplaces. Give Kaiser Heating and Cooling a call today. Proudly serving the Yankton area since 1948.
Thursday, and don't forget about the 465 dinners to go. When you're in a hurry, just give us a call, stop in, we'll have them ready for you. Jodine's
Rest. You deserve to get good service and...
Back on the Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show, brought to you by First Dakota National Bank. We're awaiting Yankton Girls Basketball Coach Trey Creer to join us. And, boy, Michael, when they want you out, they want you out. We are in semi-darkness up here in the bleachers at Sioux Falls Lincoln. But, again, the final in the season opener for both, Sioux Falls Lincoln 36 and Yankton 22 on the Fox Stop scoreboard, brought to you by the Fox Stop, located on the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st Street in Yankton, open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, full-service convenience store, hot food, sandwiches, munchies, beverages, the cellar, and the video lottery room with pay-at-the-pump gas and diesel fuel with firewood and propane tank exchange. In the sub-varsity games, Yankton defeated Lincoln 40-23. Kai Lily Medina had 10 points to lead Yankton. Kaylor Llewellyn had 8, and Addison Skelhaas had 7. And in the sophomore game, Lincoln defeated Yankton 47-23. No other AA games are being played tonight or Saturday. So, again, Lincoln beating Yankton 36-22, the only AA game going on. Let's, we'll check the rest of the scores across the state of South Dakota after we have Yankton girls basketball coach Trey Creer joining us. TK, you can't be out of shape.
Yeah, Joe, I am out of shape. 4 kids will do that to me.
That's true, too.
Nice.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll find out what's up for breakfast in the Creer household when we start breakfast with the coaches coming up tomorrow morning.
You betcha.
But, Coach, 36-22, Lincoln wins. Boy, there was just a lot of shots tonight and close-in ones. And I know you're smiling, but, that's a tough way to start, you know, when you're getting those looks and they're just not falling.
Yeah, you know, I'm proud of the way our kids handled a lot of things about that game. You know, we talked about this earlier. We returned 15 points from last year's season. 10 of those are in the hands of number 10 for us. And so we got a lot of inexperienced kids out there. And to be able, 12 days into the season, to be able to handle a full court press, to be able to handle a half court trap, and to still be able to take care of the ball well enough to get those shots, number one, is a very positive thing in our eyes. Now, you know, we're gonna need to be able to finish more of those than we did tonight. I thought Macy did a good job on the interior. She got some good looks. She demanded the ball, commanded the ball into the post. We got to get her some more versatility. She's a power post player. She tries to bulldoze her way through people, and that works sometimes for us, but we got to get her some more options for situations where they're not going in. We got to get some people to move a little bit more on those interior passes and try and find some kickouts for some straight up catch and look opportunities. And Claire didn't shoot the ball very well tonight, but you know, we know what Claire can do, and we're not worried about how that's going to look going forward. If we can do the things that we did tonight and get from her what we know we're going to get from her, we're going to like where we're at. Defensively, I was really impressed with the way our kids defended. You know, we did some things tonight, Joe, that we haven't seen out of our Gazelles teams for a couple of years. We defended the ball screen extremely well. We had good hard show by our post players. Macy did a good job. Camilla did a good job on that. Cameron Koletsky did a good job on that for us. And that really takes them out of the things that they want to run. So I got to do a little bit better shoring up some offensive rebounds on their end. But for the most part, defensively, really happy with the 36-point effort that we just put forward.
And, you know, you talk about Macy Drotzman. And, of course, Macy kind of showed this last year. I mean, she is tough in the lane. Like you said, she demands the ball. You know, she makes good post moves and everything like that. She battles for rebounds inside. I think that's a part of outside your program that really people don't know about her.
Right. And you know, she's a kid who's put in a lot of work for us over the course of the summers and really worked on her inside game, trying to get her to kind of expand a little bit out. She's actually got quick feet. So, you know, she's a little bit undersized compared to some other post players who are going to guard us. But if we can get her to get a little bit more space, face the basket up a little bit more, I think we can get a little bit more out of her even than what we saw tonight.
All right. Well, not much turnaround. Back home on Tuesday against the Huron Tigers, I hear Tim Buddenhagen has now taken the boys, and there's a new girls coach at Huron as well. But it'll be good to take a look at tape, work on some things, but right back in action Tuesday, which is really what you want. You want games now that you've had practices and you've had a game under your belt.
Yeah, we're going to get some rest here tomorrow, get a little Coach Rosie session in for our kids, and then good rest day on Sunday and a good pregame practice on Monday to get ready for the Huron Tigers. They're a good team, and they're a young team. They've got a couple of Hines girls who seems like they just keep coming through the program, but they can both score the basketball. They got a couple of kids who were eighth graders last year who scored a lot of points in their sub-varsity games. So we're going to have to be ready defensively, and then we're going to have to be ready to shoot the ball a little bit better than we did today.
All right, game number one under the belt. Coach Creer, thanks for the visit. We'll talk to you tomorrow morning on Breakfast with the Coaches.
You bet. Thanks, Joe.
All right, Trey Creer, the girls' basketball coach at Yankton High School here on the Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show, brought to you by the First Dakota National Bank. Michael tells me we need one more break, and we'll take that. We'll be back to wrap things up from Sioux Falls Lincoln after this on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, and 5-star streaming.
Sometimes trapped at work, surrounded by four walls, working the same task daily? Well, here's an opportunity. Larry's is hiring for installers and service technicians. These positions mean that you are out and about at a job site with a different situation every day. No experience needed, we will train you. Larry's offers great pay and benefits. Apply for our installer or service technician position by stopping by our Yankton location at 2401 Broadway Avenue or online at larrysheatingandcooling.com.
What are some reasons you choose?
Sometimes trapped at work, surrounded by four walls.
How about locally owned and operated and maintained A-plus rating all the
time? Tuxedo is proud to have been part of the Yankton community since its start in 2000.
One of the things I love most is that they believe in promoting from within. I've been given many opportunities to advance.
Tuxedo has an extensive variety of benefits available to their employees.
The work environment at Tuxedo is extremely positive.
We are looking for you to join our production team. Visit www.tuxedo.com/careers to apply.
Press anytime, any day, Comfort Care Club to help keep your HVAC system running
at RB Grill House and Sports Bar in Yankton. Wing Wednesday is a huge hit. The burgers, steaks, ribs, fish, and daily specials, mouthwatering for sure. And the adult beverages, well, just look at the spirits and taps selection. They're open Tuesday through Sunday at 11:30. Bring the family and enjoy a game of checkers while you await your feast. RB Grill House and Sports Bar is located at 2901 Broadway in Yankton. Dine in, delivery, and carry out. Call them or stop out today. Bring the family and enjoy a game of checkers.
Your number one Yankton High School fans, Auto Owners Insurance and MT and RC Smith Insurance of Yankton is a winning combination. They'll work with you to insure your home, auto, business, and life to keep everything you value safe, sound, secure. Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people. Call MT and RC Smith Insurance in Yankton today at 665-3611.
New items are made regularly. Lotus Soaps and Company in Yankton even takes...
At Avera, we believe good health starts early and that good health care can inspire a life of wellness. At Avera, we believe in push-ups and pumping iron. We believe less is more. And live for apple slices instead of apple pie. At Avera, we live for staying healthy and enjoying the little things. We're invested in healthy living so you can live longer.
If you're interested, bringing live high school sports streaming to you, Fuller Digital Solutions. Look us up on YouTube.
All right, back with Michael Schumacher at the Sioux Falls Lincoln Gym. Again, Sioux Falls Lincoln defeats Yankton 36-22 to go to 1-0. They will be playing Sioux Falls Washington, one of the top teams in girls AA next Thursday. The Gazelles 0-1 will have their first ESD conference matchup with the Huron Tigers at the Yankton High School Summit Activities Center Gym at 7 o'clock next Tuesday night, and that will be seen and heard on five-star streaming only because of USD men's basketball Tuesday night on Classic Hits 106.3 and USD women's basketball on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570. Well, here I was prepared to give you Class A and Class B scores from around the state, but none are final, so what's the use? We'll have those scores from southeastern South Dakota on the first full night of girls basketball in South Dakota coming up tomorrow morning on the sports on Classic Hits 106.3 in the 7 and 8 o'clock hours. And don't forget Breakfast with the Coaches on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK.com, as we'll visit with our Yankton and Vermilion high school coaches. Well, again, in sub-varsity action, Yankton won the JV game 40-23. Kai Lily Medina had 10 points, and Lincoln won the sophomore game 47-23. Michael, final thoughts before we close it out?
Oh, I think the Gazelles did pretty well tonight. I think we can say, you know, they kind of went cold from the free throw line at the end, had some good shots that they, if they'd made, would have been a different story. So I think they're going to be a good team to watch as they get some more experience throughout this season.
All right, and Michael, good luck to you as you start off as the voice of Vermilion High School girls and boys basketball. Tanagers will host Canton in Dakota 12 conference action on Monday night at the Vermilion High School gym on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK.com, and on Vermilion streaming from YouTube. Thanks for being the chauffeur tonight. Thank your parents for the use of a vehicle.
Not a problem. I will definitely do that.
All right. Yankton High School basketball has been brought to you by First National Bank Omaha, FNBO, at the corner of 4th and Broadway in Yankton. Full-service banking, mortgage, ag, commercial, small business, free checking, savings, and credit cards. Your great big small bank, FNBO, member FDIC. And, again, our post-game sponsor, First Dakota National Bank. They have proudly supported the dreams and banking needs of our customers for over 150 years. They offer personal, business, and ag banking solutions for every stage of your journey with two locations, downtown and North Broadway, Yankton. We're also brought to you by our Yankton Sportscaster Club members who bring you Bucks and Gazelles athletics on five-star communications and on five-star streaming. For Michael Schumacher, Joe Van Goor, we bid you good night from the Sioux Falls Lincoln High School gym in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. You've been listening to and watching Yankton High School girls basketball on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK Vermilion Yankton, online at kvtk.com and on five-star streaming from YouTube.
Thank you for your